Jackery 5000 and the Delta Pro Ultra are two of the biggest, most powerful, and largest power stations on the market. We have full review videos on each of these, and we've recommended both of them on the channel before. But when it comes to spending your hard-earned money, you guys have been asking us which one's best. So today, we're going to be putting them head-to-head to determine if you should buy
this or that.
This or that.
So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. When both of these units launched, they really impressed us. They were two of the biggest plug-and-play power stations that you could buy, and the best option for home backup without going the traditional solar kit route. As always, we'll have discount codes and links to both units down in the description below, along with information on this month's giveaway. But aside from that, let's put these things in a ring and see who comes out on top. Starting off with capacity, the Jackery has a 5,040 watt-hour battery, while EcoFlow has 6,144. So for the first point, we're going to give that one to EcoFlow. Both of them have 7,200 watt inverters, so that's a tie for the output. The Jackery in our testing did surge a bit better though. EcoFlow doesn't really have the best history of surging beyond its rated output. So for the surge point, we're going to give it to Jackery. Moving on to solar input, EcoFlow has a total of 5,600 watts of input. It has a high and a low input, similar to the Jackery, but the Jackery only has a total of 4,000 watts. So that's an easy point for the EcoFlow. EcoFlow also takes the AC input point. Both have standard 1800 watt inputs, though EcoFlow has a ton of accessories for fast charging. You can get the EV charger, the generator charger, and we've even seen this get up to over 6,000 watts when charging it. So an easy point for EcoFlow. EcoFlow also takes the sound point. The Delta Pro Ultra is probably the quietest power station on the market, hands down. It literally makes no noise, even when running at full tilt. Moving on to functionality, when it comes to ports and plugs, both of them have four 120 volt plugs, both have 240 volt generator plugs, two USB-A's, two USB-C's. The EcoFlow has a 30 amp plug, which would be better for campers and RVs, where the Jackery has a 50 amp instead of a 30 amp. This gives you options for plugging it into a transfer switch, but it's less useful when plugging it into an RV or camper. Some brand new campers take 50 amps, but traditionally it's a 30 amp. Jackery also has a 12 volt car socket. So Jackery's gonna take this point with having more access to the 240 volts with the 50 amp. The screen works great on both. EcoFlow's is much cooler to look at, but honestly, they both do the exact same thing. And when it comes to UPS, both of them work fine. So overall, for the functionality point, we're giving it to Jackery. In our opinion, the EcoFlow takes home the point for look and feel. We kind of thought that this looks stupid in YouTube videos, but once you get it in your hands or you park it somewhere in your garage, it looks pretty good. It's sleek, modern, and just looks cleaner in your home. So that's a point for EcoFlow. But when it comes to portability, the EcoFlow does fall short. It's built for home backup, so the inverter actually has to be removed from the batteries if you're gonna pick it up. In most cases, it's gonna be a two-person lift, unless you're tiny baby. Well, the Jackery has a suitcase handle and wheels. And it also has a hidden handle underneath if you're wanting to do a team lift. So overall, the Jackery is just a little bit more portable and easier to move around. When it comes to expandability though, the Jackery can only be scaled to 60 kilowatt hours, whereas the Delta Pro Ultra can be scaled to 90. Let's be honest here, no one's probably gonna scale it to max out either one of those numbers, but when it comes to scalability, EcoFlow does take this point. There's gonna be one dude who's like, I maxed it out.
I have two shits. I'm fully maxed out. Okay? They're both running into my house and it's the best $1 million I've ever spent.
Neither one of them though has good customer support. And for a company like EcoFlow, honestly, they need to step up their game. We mystery shopped them not too long ago and didn't have the best experience. So for this point, we're gonna give them a tie. Neither one of them is really better than the other, which is kind of embarrassing considering that they're supposed to be leaders in the space. For Robbie's rants and requirements, Jackery has a 12 volt car socket, which is kind of funny for a unit like this, and neither one of them has a light. So Robbie says Jackery gets a point. And finally, the price. The EcoFlow right now is $4,699, while the Jackery is $3,499. It does have a smaller battery, but that's still a pretty significant price difference. We broke it down to price per watt hour. EcoFlow, you're paying about 76 cents, and Jackery, you're paying about 69 cents. So at the end of the day, this one was really close, but in our opinion, we do agree with the points. The EcoFlow is quieter and it's a bit of a better unit. Not only is the EcoFlow quieter, but it has a wider range of accessories. It's also part of a larger ecosystem. You could use it in your RV or for home backup. Unless you need something that you're planning to move around often, EcoFlow would definitely be the choice that we would make. If your heart is set on Jackery, it's still a great unit. We really liked it, but we would recommend to our friends to get the EcoFlow. So that's pretty much all we got. Like always, check down below in the description for any coupons and links to the products that we just talked about. Otherwise, we will catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out and stay charged.